Hi, my name is Ajay Agarwal. I live in Pune, in Vanavri. I'm a very green enthusiast. I love growing my own food. In fact, I love growing my own oxygen. And now I grow almost everything which I'd like to eat. And I sort of work backward in terms of anything which I like, I start growing. And now I have moved from organic to, in the last 1 year, I have moved from organic to permaculture, which is more sustainable, which means I use all the waste around me, waste available in my garden, in my society. I use that to create my own, medium, growing medium. And it's much more sustainable. Now we are only Karela and Turain here. I had a very long stint of cucumbers here, which we just got over, just removed. Karela is also going. So, and we have Karelas. We have Karelas also. We got quite a lot, huge crop. So just because of two vines, they used to give me. So that's the beauty of permaculture. And I mean, permaculture is something which is the future of organic farming. Then I try and make best use of everything. Like these, I'm growing cherry tomatoes in pots. I've got this hanging pot. They look nice. They're beautiful. Plus also, the chilies. If you see in a pot like this, small pot, but it's fully loaded. Then I also have a lot of. This is my green patch here completely. So I have lettuce, celery, spinach, Swiss chard, and this is some Australian salad. And leek. There is a leek. Then here I'm growing ginger and potatoes. I've started potato experiment now. And I'll show you, come there, I'll show you. Brussels sprouts, again this year is coming up now. This is my artichoke. It's coming up now, looking very nice. Now these are my two trees, for example, in pots of sitafal. And you'll be surprised that I get enough sitafal in the season. I just finished the season. I'm getting ready for the next season now. I'll go there. This is a butternut squash. You can see the pumpkin there, the big fruit lying there in the corner there. So yeah, and that's jicama. That's another vine of jicama. This also I started last year. This experimented, it was successful. So yeah, I just keep trying whatever I come to know. I try, and fortunately, it all works. You know. So this is a kumquat. I had my first crop few weeks ago, where I actually made a big bottle of marmalade. These are all beetroot and radish. Let me see if I can show you some radish fruit. I'll pull out some in this. There must be some. So in a pot like this, you can actually grow radish very easily. See, like this. This is beetroot. This is another green which we eat, very yummy. Then I have lemon, I have jamun, I have chikus, I've got pomegranates. So yeah, I mean, I try to do whatever I can, and fortunately even fruits I get quite a lot of quantity here. Pot, I can grow a proper tree and I've got good crop, and we enjoy sufficient quantity of pomegranate through this. And we get chikus throughout the year. Finished one crop in there now, with very few left, but fresh flowering has started already. There are some guavas, you can see. These are broccoli sprouts, and these are all spinach, white chard, Swiss chard, leek, and chives. Then again, fresh coriander, my fresh lettuce. Rocket, some wild rocket. This is pok choy, you can see. healthy bok choy. This is bok choy. This is a different variety of bok choy. The kale for salads. Again, some more different rocket. So we need, and we, as you see, we've got a lot of variety. So I don't think we have a problem on variety. And whenever I feel like I find something new, I start growing it. So that's the way it works. So practice, and I think it's not just healthy; it's sustainable. It will add. You will contribute to the environment and the purity of the oxygen. You will add oxygen to your own neighborhood. As I said, you will generate your own oxygen if nothing else. And it's not difficult at all. And it's not expensive. There's some cost to set it up, but you can always do it at a much lesser cost. Like I'm using pots, but you can use containers. You can use bags. So that's not a problem at all. But my dream is that everybody should do it on their own, whatever space is available. Even if you don't have a terrace, you can do it in balcony. And one of the reasons I built hydroponic system was that I want people to practice hydroponics in their balconies.
What is hydroponics?
So in hydroponics, I earlier used to grow everything, but now I've stuck to only the greens. And there are big bucket hydroponics where I grow cucumbers and tomatoes. These are bengans, you can see. All kind of bengans are growing here. It's not difficult at all. It's very easy. It's a question of whether you take personal interest or not. But a lot of people want to do it through a mali or through an external help. That won't work. Unless you are involved yourself and you do it with your own hands, it won't work. You know, the plants are like human beings. They need personal touch, you know. And if you get involved personally with your own passion, then they respond much better.
Well, you heard the man. This is Mehak Qureshi reporting for PuneKarNews.in.